This is an auto-narrated audiobook generated by Google. Book, The Belt. Author, Wallace West. Chapter 1. No one foresaw what would come of the social experiment Jonathan Robertson started early in the 18th century on this little island. And Jonathan VII found the terrible fruit of what had been sown. Rum port to come home to, if I may say so, sir. The captain spat over the rail into the blue waters. Rum? Jonathan Robertson, 7th, continued to study the cliffs which he had not seen for 20 years. Why? Oh, I don't know. Gives me the jumps every time I touch here. Maybe it's the name, New Patmos. Yes, St. John did have a rough time when he was exiled on the original Isle of Patmos, didn't he? And then there's that gang on the dock. It's just old Tom and some of my father's workmen. I know. The captain relit his pipe. But any other Caribbean port I stop at, the dock workers are singing and skylarking. Those fellows never say a word. Rum, I call it. Some of my crew think their jumbies won't set foot on shore here. Jumbies are one thing I can assure you they're not, Captain, Jonathan chuckled. They're just plain workmen, and English to boot. As for the old Tom, he carried me on his shoulders when I was a kid. Cheerio, Tom, he continued after the lines had been made fast and the ebony-colored ancient was clambering over the rail. Where's father? I'm sorry, sir. The answer came in the clipped British accent of the West Indies. Your father is dead, sir, these 2 weeks. Dead. A picture of the 6th Jonathan Robertson, austere in his white linens, flashed through Jonathan's mind. It seemed impossible that he was no longer striding on his daily rounds to the factory and mine. Yes, sir. Perhaps we'd better go up to the house at once, sir, if you don't mind. I'll tell the men to follow with the cargo. Tom turned to the leaden-faced, overall-clad trio on the pier and shouted, Men? Take cargo to storehouse. Bill. Ye can? Yeah, grunted the man on the left. Fred. Ye can? Cargo to storehouse? Yeah. The tone was identical. Dick. Ye can? Yeah. Tom picked up Jonathan's bags and led the way up a rocky path which eventually rounded a cliff which had hidden the Robertson mansion. It was a pleasant enough place, although sadly in need of paint. A grove of palm trees half concealed the ravages which time had made on its tall pillars. The house had an atmosphere of peace and quiet, but the effect was spoiled by an ugly factory which clung to the cliffside on the other side of the valley. Although it was Sunday, Jonathan noticed that smoke was belching from the factory chimney. I know it's ungodly this working on the Sabbath, sir, said Tom as his new master stared, but they will work all the time. Even during the funeral. He broke off and hobbled forward to swing the door of the mansion open. Everything was orderly inside. Lattices were drawn to keep out the equatorial sun, teakwood floors gleamed, dozens of canaries twittered in their cages near the windows. This way, sir. Jonathan climbed a winding staircase, which seemed smaller than he remembered it.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.